Lions get it back for Steed. Pass down low, didn't connect. Blasted up the wall by Lindholm, and this will be another icing call. 41.9 seconds to go.
Kessler won that draw, but it hit the skate of Kevin Bieksa, and then the Flames were able to get control. But couldn't direct anything at the net. Kessler brings it, and it's off Kevin Bieksa, and the Flames do a good job retrieving the puck.
Kessler wins this draw. Bieksa surrounded, chips it off the glass. Giordano keeps the play onside. Down low for Backlund to Brouwer. Behind that to Backlund, fires it around. Giordano hustles over. Keeps the play alive. Backlund threw it out front. Chip just wide by Monahan. And again, the Ducks ice the puck. 18.4 seconds left in the third.
Mark Giordano is getting tired just chasing the icings. So without Hampus Lindholm, is he back on the bench in 3-6? No, he's not. Kevin Bieksa is logging a lot of ice time.
Monahan and Kessler again. Flames get the puck. Chris Steed. Giordano can't get to it. Stolen by Getzlaff with the empty net. Ryan Getzlaff scores! And that should seal it with 6.7 seconds to go. The Anaheim Ducks are about to move on to round two.
And look at the Duck bench, and that's the kind of enthusiasm you want from your team, even though they're ahead 3-0. Close it out. And how appropriate is that that Ryan Getzlaff gets the empty netter? Very aggressive. Off his body, waits till he gets the red line, and then makes no mistake.
Third goal of these playoffs for Getzlaff. 104th National Hockey League playoff point for number 15. As the final seconds tick down, the Ducks complete their fifth sweep in franchise history. A birthday present for 61-year-old Randy Carlyle's John Gibson gets the win. And the Ducks are moving on to round two.
A bounce back game for John Gibson. He was the difference in this one. The Flames, those two early goals against, and John Gibson made them pay and made it stand up. And Randy Carlyle goes over and congratulates the Flames coaching staff. I would say Ryan Getzlaff, best player for the Ducks, and Sean Monahan for the Calgary Flames, who really did not deserve to get swept. They played four very good games. Could have gone either way.
Chad Johnson forced in early in the first. Gave up one goal. Was solid the rest of the way for the Flames.
Here's the handshakes.
And the crowd at Scotiabank Saddledome showing their appreciation for the season Calgary had, but it ends quickly in the playoffs. They were back in for the second time in 3 years after missing a season ago.
Well, I remember back in November, in the middle of November, and it looked like the Flames had no chance whatsoever. And people were talking about Glenn Gullickson. Was he really the right guy? And I think Glenn Gullickson and the Flames proved that, yeah, he was the right guy. They just got their goaltending turned around, got their structure, their power play started to work, and belief in the system. You bring in a new coaching staff, you have to believe in the system. And the Flames started to do that, got on a run, and made the playoffs.
Sweeps reminded you a little bit of the Ducks win over Winnipeg in a sweep 2 years ago.
Yes, it did.
Games especially were close to that series. Let's head down to ice level. Roger Millian standing by.
All right, Rick, thanks very much. Andrew Cogliano, congratulations on your sweep. You guys found a way each and every night. It wasn't always pretty, but can you comment on how you were able to get the job done?
Yeah, I think at the end of the day, I think our 5-on-5 was the difference. You know, we were able to score goals. We were able to shut Goudreau down on 5-on-5, and I think that, you know, sometimes plays to be the difference. They had a good power play, but at the end of the day, we got it done.
Your experience seemed to really show, particularly in this hockey game. You got the early lead, and you just wouldn't give much up. A great goaltending by John Gibson.
Yeah, I think we've been there. You know, I think we're experienced to know how to play at the end of the game and know what to do to win. So hopefully that continues.
And you're going to get some rest before round two, which is important.
Yeah, we need some guys feeling healthy. We got some banged up guys, but it was a good series. When beating this team 4-0 is a tough job.
Congratulations, Andrew.
Thank you.
Andrew Cogliano, Rick and John, back
all
to
right.
you.
Thank you, Roger. As the Flames make their way off the ice, salute the fans here at Scotiabank Saddledome. Ducks move on to round two. They'll get a break. We mentioned earlier the Oilers and the Sharks are going at least six games. So, you know, we talked about Lindholm leaving the game late in the third. So they're banged up on the blue line. A break may be exactly what they need as Roger Millions one more time standing by this time with Ryan Getzlaff.
Indeed, I am, Rick Ball. Ryan, congratulations on your four-game sweep with the Calgary Flames. Just a comment on what it took to get this done 4 in a row against a team that didn't want to give up very much.
Yeah, it took a lot of work. They showed a lot of resilience. We give them a lot of credit for that. They battled hard right to the end here. I thought our group did a good job. Got a few bounces here and there, but we worked for them.
But your experience showed, I know a couple years ago you were not happy with what happened. You haven't been happy in the playoffs recently, but it seems like you're a determined group. Is this group got a bit of a different mental attitude this time around?
Well, I think every year. I mean, anyone who doesn't win the Cup's disappointed. So as a group, the last couple of years, we fell a little bit short. But we took one step now, and we got to get ready for the next one.
And that's a great attitude to have. Going forward now, you're going to have a few days. San Jose and Edmonton are going to be at least a few days before they get done. How important will that be for you to get ready for the winner of that series?
Well, it's good all the time. I mean, anytime we can use the rest and make sure our group's ready and prepared. We've done it throughout the year, so we expect nothing else.
Ryan, congratulations on the rest of the playoffs.
Thank you.
Captain of the Anaheim Ducks, Ryan Getzlaff. He leads his team to a four-game sweep. Rick and John, back to you.
Thank you, Roger. And Getzlaff gets the empty netter that seals this 3-1 victory in Game 4. John, three stars tonight.
I thought Nate Thompson, Randy Carlyle with the move in Game 3 to put Nate Thompson a line up. He really responded. 4 points in his last two games. Sean Monahan, by far the best of the Calgary Flames around the net and making the power play goal. 4 power play goals in 4 games. And John Gibson, what a bounce back game for him. Gets the hook in Game 3, is chuckling on the bench, so maybe that's the way to go. Kelly and I'll have to rethink our goaltending